Hey guys, it is well known that China is a country obsessed with creating colossal mega projects to accommodate its ever-expanding population. American engineers admit that when it comes to mega projects construction, there is no country in the world that can match China. Nowadays, China is truly deserving of the title construction magician. These projects have left many foreigners in awe, and it's evident that China's reputation for engineering prowess is well deserved. It seems that China's construction boom is about to ignite once again. In this edition, let's take a look at the mega projects engineering projects that have impressed American engineers. But before we show you these projects, we earnestly ask for your support by liking this video and subscribing to Machine Eye. Currently, only 5% of our viewers are subscribed. Help us to get this number to 10%. We value your thoughts and invite you to share your views on these remarkable engineering feats in the comments below. Without further ado, let's embark on this extraordinary journey. Now, let's continue. First, let's introduce a bridge that the United States couldn't solve. The Hamilton Bridge in New York City, spanning the Harlem River, is a crucial transportation artery for the area. However, due to its age, safety concerns arose, prompting the United States to invite international bids from engineering teams. Naturally, China won the bid. But could the United States accept this? Constructing this bridge posed numerous challenges. The United States kept throwing obstacles, demanding stringent conditions to ensure existing traffic wouldn't be affected during construction. Why build a new bridge? Because the old one was damaged. Who would continue using something that's broken? Any other country's engineers would have given up facing such difficulties. But China is different. Not only did China help the United States repair the bridge, but the engineering quality also fully met American standards. Trying to trouble Chinese engineers is simply wishful thinking. Let's move on to the world's longest dam, built by Chinese engineers in Sudan. The Sudanese Mero Dam, located about 350 kilometers north of the capital, Khartoum, spans 1.1 miles, making it the world's longest dam. Considering that China's Three Gorges Dam is only 2,000 kilometers long, the Mero Dam is practically the second Three Gorges Dam. When Sudan first issued a global tender, hardly any country, including the United States, dared to respond because the budget for this project was too low to be profitable. China stepped up and took on the project. After reaching an agreement, a team of Chinese experts was sent to assist in the construction. Initially, the construction faced difficulties as Sudan lacked the industrial and economic strength to use advanced materials. This forced China to devise a simple earth and stone plan. However, Sudan's engineers lacked sufficient technical expertise, so Chinese engineers had to be hands-on, simultaneously building the dam and teaching the Sudanese engineers. Soon, skilled Sudanese engineers emerged, and together with China, they overcame numerous challenges. After the dam was completed, Sudan experienced a significant leap in its national strength. However, as American experts had predicted, the project's budget was severely insufficient, leaving China with little profit. So why did China help Sudan build the dam? The reason is simple. China aimed to expand cooperation with African countries. Upon completion, Sudan placed great trust in China, leading to numerous collaborations between the two nations. China has now become one of the most welcomed countries in Africa. Behind China's title of construction magician, few know that China encountered tremendous challenges while constructing an ultra-long tunnel, digging 14 kilometers and only managing a little over 2 kilometers per year. This is certainly not fitting for the title of China's construction magician. The tunnel, the longest in North Africa, was deemed a disaster by French engineers due to its complex geological conditions. China's engineers spent nearly 7 years conquering this challenge. The tunnel's success highlighted China's construction capabilities, leading many countries to entrust their infrastructure projects to China. Today, China's influence in Africa has gradually surpassed that of France, moving on to large-scale projects within China's borders. Before the project was even completed, it drew worldwide attention. Electricity construction has always been a focal point of China's future, as its vast population demands increasing energy year by year. With many economic facilities relying on water transport in inland China, hydraulic engineering is indispensable. Although the construction of the Three Gorges Dam significantly improved China's power supply, it still couldn't meet the country's current electricity demands. China is known for its advanced hydraulic engineering, and the West-East Electricity Transmission Project is a result of this background. The project's centerpiece is the Baihetan Hydropower Station, which has already become one of the world's largest arch dams under construction. The Baihetan Hydropower Station stands in a geographically challenging location, completed on the main course of the Jinja River. It is the second largest hydropower station downstream of the Jinja River among four large hydropower stations. In just 4 years, the hydropower station was completed and started storing water. In the following 7 months, it underwent electricity testing and grid commissioning before all units were officially put into operation. This project broke numerous world records and was as challenging as the Three Gorges Dam. The Baihetan Hydropower Station's success showcased China's formidable engineering capabilities, especially in power generation. Currently, there is no other hydroelectric power plant in Western China as powerful as this one, making it unique. However, constructing such large units was not a straightforward task for China, especially given its location in an earthquake-prone area. The basic requirements were for it to be earthquake-resistant, robust, reliable, and durable. To complete the dam's casting, construction personnel had to dig and deliver materials simultaneously. Geologically, the natural dam foundation of the Jinja River area is not solid, mostly composed of basalt, which is prone to cracks due to its many fractures. To mitigate this, China's engineering team used low-heat cement during casting, ensuring minimal heat release to prevent cracking. Additionally, they invented seamless construction joint technology to make the spillway tunnel appear mirror smooth. Ultimately, the spillway tunnel completed the flood discharge test, releasing water at a speed of 48 kilometers per second, becoming the world's largest group of unpressurized spillway tunnels. Undoubtedly, the Baihetan Hydropower Station is an essential project in China's water management plan. It will provide ample electricity to eastern China while contributing significantly to global green, low-carbon, and environmental protection efforts. In just one day, the power generated by the Baihetan Hydropower Station can meet the annual electricity consumption of over 500,000 households. With the sturdy underground cavity, these large generators can now be safely placed for operation. Despite differing opinions on environmental concerns, this marks China's future energy direction, transitioning from traditional to clean energy. With the advancement of new water management plans, China is set to go further on the path to clean energy. In recent years, China has continuously constructed large-scale engineering projects, increasing investment in new projects and establishing a high-level technological innovation pattern in infrastructure. China's new infrastructure is facing unprecedented development opportunities. With its massive market, complete industrial system, and the original intention of China's Development Foundation, implementing new infrastructure has all the necessary conditions. In terms of technology maturity, the deep integration of digital technology in the real economy gives China an advantage with a wealth of data and diverse application scenarios, conducive to accomplishing new infrastructure tasks with existing technology. China's infrastructure not only brings convenience to its citizens, but has also started to extend beyond its borders, helping other countries improve their infrastructure. China's infrastructure endeavors have not only helped other countries achieve modernization, but have also brought numerous benefits to China. It's a win-win situation. China's remarkable engineering and construction strength has left many foreigners believing that China is already a developed country. How do you view these evaluations? We would love to hear your thoughts and insights in the comment section below. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel to stay updated with more fascinating content. Thank you for watching, and we look forward to seeing you in the next video. Take care and goodbye.